this year, Finland is celebrating 20 years of EU membership. Could you point out the three major achievements of this membership and also the three main challenges, if there are any, in this period?
Well, 20 years ago or 25 years ago when we started negotiating, of course, I mean, I could almost say that the opportunities and the challenges were the same, because we wanted to enter the internal market, really. So that meant that our competitiveness had to grow a lot, but we could gain markets. And of course, it meant that Europe would open for us in every way. And this is a challenge, and this is also an opportunity. I think the biggest, let's say, question in the accession negotiations where the northern agriculture, how to really try to get the European partners to understand that we want to keep Arctic agriculture in our country.
Finland is among the top EU countries considering the absorption rate of European funds. Do you have any secrets to this success? Maybe something you could make like a recommendation for Romanian system, because you are here. Maybe you learn something about what's happening in Romania. What are your comments on this question?
Well, I would say that let's say that the absorption, how to get funds, it must be built on a strategy. What the country needs, what are the needs that the country has. And then you have to have very good planning, very good coordination between the different actors, both on national level and then on regional level. And I think that we have managed to do this, that all actors in Finland, and then good expertise to give advice on how to get the funds to those institutions or persons who would be then seeking the funds. A very good planning and coordination and a lot of good expertise.
So the authorities are supporting the potential beneficiaries to access the funds?
Yes, we have certain regional employment, certain regional centers that, yes, they give advice. They give advice.
Finland is often mentioned also as a good practice in the policies regarding youth, especially the youth guarantee. It's among the first countries which implemented this initiative, European initiative. Can you explain a little what happened regarding the youth guarantee or other examples of projects dedicated to youth?
Yes, we don't, of course, have very many years of experience of the youth guarantee yet. But as you know, that it's open for every young person under 25, and then it's even open to every young person who has graduated in the last 12 months and is looking for a job, who is under 30. So in Finland, we have the experience that the unemployment periods for young people, they have become shorter thanks to this youth guarantee, that the authorities have to give advice of employment or either employment or training possibilities. So it is still in the, let's say, starting phase in a way, but it is certainly helping the bad situation of youth unemployment that we have actually everywhere, almost everywhere in Europe.
In Romania also, but the initiatives in Romania in the youth sector are still in a very starting phase. made some comments about the cooperation and verification mechanism of the European Union in relation with Romania, with the Romanian authorities' declarations on this issue, and also about the Schengen area. I would like to ask you again, what is your opinion on these two aspects?
I think that the cooperation and verification mechanism has been very good for Romania to developing the Romanian institutions, to increase the fight against corruption, which is a plague all over the world, and it's also in Europe. So I think that the mechanism has been very beneficial, and a lot of Romanians who I talk to, they find it very beneficial. Of course, I understand that sometimes the authorities might be irritated that they have this kind of mechanism in place for a European Union member state, but on the other hand, it makes the authorities really to try to be efficient and speedy in achieving the results that are needed for lifting this mechanism. So I think that we share the same goal in this. And I always, when I talk to Romanians about this, I say that it is a good mechanism. It's not there to harm you. It's there to make you better, to improve you, and to protect your citizens. So it will be lifted one day, and the speedier the Romanian authorities act, the quicker it will be lifted, I'm sure of that. About Schengen, I told yesterday in another interview that yes, it's true that Finland opposed Schengen accession of Romania and Bulgaria 4 years ago, and since then, actually, this matter has not come up in Brussels to a formal decision stage. So, I mean, we have been following in Finland very carefully and very closely the developments in Romania. And when this Schengen matter comes up to decision again, we will certainly take a new look at it. I mean, until now, it has not been necessary to really reformulate anything new. We have said that Romania fulfills the technical criteria. That this is true, but we were looking at the situation as a whole, like we said. We were looking at the corruption and functioning of the institutions, and we see that there is improvement in this. But, I mean, the day when Schengen comes up to a decision again, our government will discuss it and look at the situation, with a view to the developments that have taken place in the past years.
And to conclude, a message for the Romanians with the occasion of the Europe Day.
Romanians, you are our partners. We are together in Europe. So let's make Europe a really good place to live and work, and for us and for the future generations.
Thank you very much.